Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to do this value mixture problem using one variable. A store sells Colombian coffee for $4 per pound and French coffee for $7 per pound. They decide to make a 120-pound blend and sell it for $5 a pound. How many pounds of each type of coffee should be used? All right, so we're going to make a little picture. So we've got Colombian coffee, I'll put COL, and we're going to mix that with some French coffee, I'll call French coffee. And we're going to get this big blend. I'm going to call it the mix because mix, blend, I think of a mixture problem. So I need to know how many pounds of each to use, and I'm not told how much Colombian or how much French, but I do know there are 120 pounds in the mixture. Now, for those of you who know how to solve systems of equations with two variables and two unknowns, you can do this using two variables. I'm going to use a single variable. So let's say I'm going to call the Colombian coffee, the amount of Colombian coffee I want to use, C. So C pounds, that might stand for 100 pounds, for instance. And I need to know what to put in for how many pounds of French coffee. But all I know is there are 120 pounds total. So let's see, if C was 100, I would know that would be 20, right? If C was 90, I'd know this would have to be 30. To get that, I would be taking the 120 and subtracting how much Colombian I have. So that's exactly what I do here. I take the 120 and I subtract however much Colombian I have, which is a variable, so I just have to write 120 minus C. Now, what do I know about the price per pound of each coffee? Well, the Colombian sells for $4 per pound up here. Right? $4 per pound for the Colombian. So I know if I want to write the price per pound down here, cost per pound for the Colombia, that's just four. Now I'm doing it in dollars. If you wanted to do it in cents, you would write 400. Now what about the French coffee? So for the French coffee, let's see, what do I have? French coffee, $7 per pound. So the cost per pound of the French coffee is seven. And the mixture should be somewhere in between. That would be the idea of mixing a more expensive with a cheaper brand, blend. You would have something in between. You don't want to add it. So somewhere in between $4 and $7. $5 seems reasonable. Now, what can we do from here? I can figure out how much the Colombian costs, how much the French costs, right? So let's see. I want to write down what the total cost of each type of coffee would be. Well, for the Colombian, it would be $4 for every pound, and I've got C pounds. So I would multiply the four times the C. For the French, it costs $7 per pound, and I have 120 minus C. So you need to multiply 7 times 120 minus C, and make sure you put that 120 minus C in parentheses. So the total cost, if I just, took C pounds of Colombian and 120 minus French, would be 4C plus 7 times 120 minus C. And we want that to be the same as it would cost if we just had a mixture already done, putting the right amount of each blend in here, at $5 a pound for all 120 pounds. Okay, so my equation is right here. I could buy the two separately, right? Or I could just buy all of it, all 120 pounds, at $5 per pound. So this is the equation we want. Now, if you don't like that C, you could change it to an X. I just did it for C, so at the end I'm going to remember that C stands for the how many pounds of Colombian coffee. So our next step is to solve this equation. And so first step will be to do the distributive property over here, but don't forget to write the 4c plus, and let's distribute the 7. So we've got 7 times 120. Let's see, 7 times 12 is 84, so I have a 0. So 840 minus 7 times c is 7c. And 5 times 120 on the other side, well, 5 times 12 is 60, add a 0. So if I combine like terms over here on the left, I have 4c minus 7c, that's going to be negative 3c plus 840 equals 600. Now you can go ahead and put the video on pause and finish solving this on your own, by the way. Whoops, went a little bit too far. Here we go. All right, so we're to this point. Now, different ways people solve from here. You could subtract 840 from both sides, right? Getting the variables on one side and constants on the other. And then go ahead and divide by negative 3. So I'm going to do that. Probably that's the most common way people solve this, but that isn't the only way. So I'm going to subtract 840 from both sides. So I still have my negative 3c. I got to be careful here. I'm adding a positive and a negative number, and there's more negatives. So the answer is negative. So I need to subtract the 840 minus the 600. So that's 240. So this is negative 240. Be careful with your subtraction there. And now I need to get c isolated, so I divide by negative 3, so I have 1c. So I got c is, well, negative divided by negative is positive, which I hope it's going to be positive because we can't put in a negative number of pounds of coffee. And then 240 divided by 3, well, 3 goes into 24, 8, and we got that extra 0. So c stands for what? So we know we're going to use 80 pounds of the Colombian coffee. See, I remembered that C stood for the pounds of Colombian coffee because I use that letter C. Now, we also need to find out how much of the French coffee. So let's go back up to the problem here. Right, what do we have here? Oops, that's the wrong problem. Right, so here's our problem. We had the value mixture problem. We had Colombian coffee and French, and we knew we had a 120-pound blend. So remember there were 120 pounds total? So if C was 80, 80 plus what would give you 120? That should tell you how much French coffee. So that would be 40 pounds of the French. So we had 80 pounds of the Colombian, 40 pounds of the French. This should be our answer, right? But we definitely want to check it. So I think that's going to be correct. You know, we could say, all right, that's how much we're going to use. But let's go ahead and check our problem to make sure. So remember, we are mixing the Colombian with the French to get our mixture. And let's go back and remind ourselves how much each of those cost. We could fill in the 80 and the 40 and the 120 right now. We know that part. So let's see, what was the dollar amount? It costs $4 a pound for the Colombian, 7 for the French, 5 for the mixture. So we know down here was the 4, the 7, and the 5. And so let's see, how much would it have cost for each of these, you know, vats of coffee? So for the Colombian, if it was four, remember this was the price per pound. Price per pound. Okay, so for the Colombian coffee, $4 a pound, 80 pounds. So we would have $4 for every pound. That's 4 times 108, 4 times 80. And for the French, it would be 7 per pound, 40. And for the mixed, it was 5 times 120, and this should come up to being equal, right? That's one way of noticing it. That would be 120. The question is 120 plus 280 equal to 6. Oops, what am I doing here? This was 4 times 80 is not 3. There we go, 320. Right, so we could see it's true that way. Another way is actually in many, you'd say, well, you've bought for the Colombian, you bought 80 at $4 a pound, so that would have cost you $320. Or we had, I mean, plus we added 40 pounds at $7 a pound, which is $280. So you could see you're spending $600 total for the two. And then the question is that the same as if you bought all 120 pounds at once at $5 a pound? And that also was 600. So since those are the same, it would have made sense that we used the right amount for each. And the question was how much of each type to use? So you would say use 80 pounds of Colombian coffee and 40 pounds of French coffee. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.